Hi everyone, I'm Jayde Lovell for Inside Science.
Inside Science TV.
We're all familiar with the butterfly effect, the analogy that the wind from a butterfly's wings or any other tiny variations can cause huge weather effects somewhere else in the world. But how do butterflies create those breezes in the first place? Well, first off, butterflies are totally the dancing queens of the animal world. They have amazing and unnecessarily huge wings for their tiny bodies. Their wings are way bigger than many other insects of the same weight. And new research shows the butterflies don't even need all that wingspan. They can still fly even when their wings are damaged or even with half their wings cut off. So how does an insect that is huge, brightly colored, and extremely visible manage to avoid getting eaten by predators? Well, those massive wings are the answer. A butterfly's massive wings enable it to turn faster. It's like having a big rudder on a ship. The bigger the rudder, the faster you can turn. Having a little rudder means you can't turn as fast, but a big rudder means you can go whoosh and turn like that. If you've ever tried to catch a butterfly, you'll know exactly what I mean. Those suckers are tricky. Butterflies also use their huge wings to create an erratic fluttering pattern, which is unique to butterflies and very hard for predators to predict. Rather than flapping up and down like a bird does, who fall victim to predators all the time, by the way, butterflies contract their bodies to make a figure eight pattern with their wings. We can model this by using this rubber ball to represent the butterfly's body and these as the wings. So as the butterfly's body contracts, it pulls the wings up and pushes air underneath them. And then as the butterfly's body returns to normal, it pushes the wings down, creating lift. Pretty cool, huh? Check out the links below for some other cool information on how butterflies fly. If you're a science geek like me, you can check out some more awesome videos from Inside Science by clicking on these links. What other topics would you like us to discuss on Inside Science? Let us know in the comments below. And of course, don't forget to subscribe.
Inside Science TV. If you enjoyed this edition, follow us on the web and social media, powered by the American Institute of Physics and a coalition of underwriters.